Hi, my name is Ben and this is Design to Make. Today we'll be building a 3D printed wire bender. Like this. Specifically designed to coil wire to different diameters, to create circles of wire of different sizes, a bit like this. If you watched my previous video, you'll know that we made this primarily to bend very springy, high tensile piano wire to form part of a 3D printed cross roller bearing. However, as part of this video, we're also going to see what other materials it can bend, maybe even looking at how easily its functionality could be extended further. Right, here we go. You can see what the complete assembly is going to look like when we build it. Pillow block, rod with some bearings to keep it centered, and a carriage. Here we can see a cross-sectional view of the assembly and the mechanics of it are on show now. So we've cut through the model, as you can see, we've cut through in line with where the bearings are. And the important point is you can see that the wire will come down here and go up here. And as we tighten this screw here, this one's got a right-handed thread and this one's a left-handed thread. When turning in the same direction, they move the nut in the opposite direction. When you turn this in a clockwise direction, it'll pull the right-handed carriage to the right or left, and it'll do the opposite with the left-handed thread, so putting it to the left or right. Moving these both towards or away from the central pulley at the same time to keep these distances here and here the same, helping us get a perfect circle. Let's print these parts. Right, so here are all the parts and necessary widgets to assemble the wire bender. Here we have the base. Here we have the bearing block, the carbon fiber axle with the accompanying bearings. It doesn't have to be carbon fiber, but I had one lying around for the previous build and I thought it looked quite good. Retainers for the axle, a little unconventional, but for a guideway for the sleds. Here I've used a maker beam, 10 millimeter maker beam I had. You could use a linear bearing shaft, a bit like this, but I'm hoping this is gonna be a bit more rigid to lateral motion. I also wanted to see how well the T-slots would work to constrain the motion to one dimension without sticking in the T-slot itself. I mean, it's basically a scaled down version of a 2020 Open Builds aluminium extrusion. I guess you could call it 1010. It's really great for building small lightweight frames and assemblies quickly. I'll pop a link to it in the description as I can't count the number of times that it's been the exact thing that I needed to build a prototype. It's really good stuff. So here are the sleds, one's with a left-handed insert, one with a right-handed insert for the threaded rod. Sled bearings with the guide house. Actually, I've printed this in polycarbonate as it's gonna have quite high forces applied to it perpendicular to the printed layers. And an earlier version I built using PLA, which didn't really last that long. So here's the central housing with the bearings to locate it in the center and the threaded inserts to hold the threaded rods and the grommets. Okay, let's put it together. Okay, so here's the assembled wire bender. Let's see how it does at bending a few different materials that may or may not be featuring in some future projects. I'd be really keen to hear in the comments section if you have any interesting ideas that it could be used for. Okay, first up, a very springy 1.2 millimeter piano wire. Next up, ductile 3 millimeter anodised aluminium wire used for crafts and is very shiny. And lastly, in a bit of a catricule on its own, 4 millimeter copper tubing with a 3 millimeter internal diameter. For the times that you've got some pipe and really just need it in a uniform coil, I'm sure we've all been there. So how does the wire bender perform on each of the materials? As you can see, it bends all of them relatively well. However, perhaps rather unsurprisingly, it does the best job of bending the springy piano wire to efficiently create a consistent reduced diameter wire coil. For both the ductile aluminium and copper materials, if you have a rod of the correct diameter, it might be just as easy to use that as a form to bend the wire around by hand. However, if you need to be able to fine-tune what exact diameter you need, or for larger diameter coils, think tin can diameter plus, a scaled up version of this wire bender would, I think, work really well. Right, so what have we achieved? We've designed and made a wire bending tool and gone on to test its wire bending prowess against a range of materials, which on the whole worked pretty well. If you've got to this point, congratulations. Please do like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this video. And I hope to see you next time. Bye for now.